Hey guys, welcome back to Let's Play Paper Mario. On the last episode, I asked you guys to vote for which level up I should take. And I am going to take badge points. Yeah, I think it was like 6 to 1 to 1 or something. So, as you've seen, I just took badge points. Woohoo! Anyway, let's actually equip a badge or two right now. Why not, right? Let's see. God, I always hate making choices like this. I'm actually thinking I'll probably go back to Toad Town and go get a Zap Tap or something. Anyway, let's see. Let's get the down jump. Yeah, we'll make him lose defense or whatever. And let's go this way. And no, that's just the way I came. Wow, I would do something like that. Sorry, my daily blonde moment. Now, anyway, let us continue on. So, in other news, super awesome news was that I got an early dismissal today. And I am going to probably not have school tomorrow, which probably means I'm not going to go visit the college I was supposed to go visit, which also probably means a double update yet again, if I'm feeling generous. Let's see. I'm feeling somewhat generous now, especially because Paper Mario is almost done. Like, oh my god. I can hardly believe it. Anyway, Star Piece. And before, had you not gone the way I had told you, that statue would have been in the way. But now it isn't, so yay. Anyway, I'm gonna skip that guy, because I'm gonna jump right over him, because he's a shorty. And shorties don't deserve my battling-ness, my battle tactics. But anyway, let us continue. Oh, skip that fight. Try that power quick. It's not such a good move. But yeah, whatever. Anyway, let us now jump forward. So yeah. How's it been hanging with you guys? You know? Me? Apparently we're having... I like how one of my teachers put it. We're gonna have snow of biblical proportions. But, c'est la vie. Anyway, this is a really easy puzzle. All you have to do is get these guys on their respective tiles. You move their statue. And you do that by talking to them. Like, yeah, you know, you talk to them first. You gotta get to know them. So then all you do is just push it in place, and each direction you talk to one of these things, right? They actually turn in that direction. Well, they turn symmetrical to that direction. So like, because I would talk right or left, that's symmetrical with the mirror. So now symmetrical with down is up. Yeah, it's just do the opposite directions for up and down, and why didn't it? Oh wow! It should have gone down. I accidentally did that. Oops. Oh well. Anyway, that opens up that, and you guys might want to make sure you have sufficient items and badges and whatnot, because yeah, we're already done with this chapter, or more or less. Surprised me. I thought there was way more, but guess not. Anyway, just continue along here. I think I'm gonna... The main party members you want to use are Paracarry, Lockalester, and Watt. I would not recommend using Bo or Goombario for this fight, simply because the boss has two points of defense, which makes both of them useless completely. If you have items, that also works in your favor, and you're about to see why. Let's see now. That is the Crystal King, I believe his official name is.
Mario, you finally arrived! I know you believe you can save the Star Spirit, but I'm afraid I won't let you. First, I shall defeat you. Then I shall present Bowser with an Ice Mario gift!
And... this guy, he has 70 HP. He's by far the toughest boss you've faced so far. Some people say he's actually the toughest in the game, but you guys can reserve judgment for that later. But anyway, so what I found kind of weird is that when I used D-Down Pound on this guy, I don't know if I thought D-Down Pound's effect was, you know, the guy loses defense, but it's just like doing the jump regardless of like, regardless of his defense points, so I don't know. But anyway, those are those little things he kept summoning are crystal bits. You want to get rid of them ASAP, hence why I'm suggesting Lackluster. I mean, you could always use Sushi, I guess, but you just need like a powerhouse that can attack all enemies, or you can use an item or whatever. So yeah, anyway, now that his ice bits are out of the way, because if you don't get them out of the way, he just throws them at you for 4 damage each. So it's 9 to 12 damage per turn. So, and as you saw actually a couple turns ago, he used an ice move where you just spit ice at me. That's very, very bad, because it can immobilize you for up to 2 turns. So, and his third attack he actually has 2 more attacks, where one is he splits up into two clones, right? And, this is what I was talking about when I said the 2 turns. But as I was saying, he splits into 3 clones, and you have to find which one is the real one. Otherwise, you know, you don't do damage to him. And that one could either be on the ground or levitating. Either way, though, I personally, at that point, use, Scholar's, Star Power move, or whatever it's called. I don't even remember what it is. Star Shower, I guess, for now. Anyway, but this is what I was talking about when he turns into these clones. And he also has another move where he just off the bat heals himself for 30 HP. Yeah, Star Storm. Wow, why did I say Star Power or Star Rain? All synonyms, I guess. Anyway, yeah, because Star Storm will attack all of them, and even if it misses the other two, it'll attack the real one. So, yeah. And as you guys know, Watt can penetrate defense. So, and this is the annoying move I was talking about. 20 HP. Down the drain. Lovely. I don't think it's too bad on the hammer front. You can use your hammer. I mean, I know I'm better with a hammer, but for some odd reason, I keep forgetting to use it. And, otherwise, you just gotta make sure you... I would definitely recommend having a life stream for this fight, because he is that annoying. Like, when I was doing my test run of this, he actually, like, this fight went on for more than, like, 12 minutes, which is why I was actually initially worried, but don't worry, it's gonna fit in the video, so, I mean, so, yeah, like, just, also, don't fret too much if, like, you start dying and stuff, because worst case scenario, you could always switch out Bo and have her do out of sight or something. But anyway, let's see. I'm going to attack Paracarry. I'm going to take out Paracarry, not attack him. And I use Air Raid on all the flying enemies, because Paracarry's specialty is flying enemies. I mean, I guess alternatively, you could have just always, you could have always used Star Storm. But, I mean, I can use that. And I have 6 HP. Lovely. Anyway, take out Watt. I swear, if this guy freaking, if he heals himself, I'm going to be so angry. It's not even funny. It's kind of funny, I guess. Not funny in a funny haha way. Like, seriously. Come on. But, oh god, I don't even have enough defense or HP or whatever. And I'm going to attack. Oh my god, I actually hit! I got the right one. Yes! No, I have 1 HP. Oh my god, no way. He didn't heal. That means, oh my god. Electro Dash, please don't mess this one up. Yes! The Electro Dash for the win. 43 star points, and imagine that had been doubled. But yeah.
Oh no, the last star spirit. King Bowser, forgive me.
And he disappears. And poofs. And... magical fairy comes out of nowhere and explodes and implodes, and out we see a card. And yeah, guys, that's really it for this chapter. I can hardly believe it, but I mean, you know, we see it right there. You got the star, which signifies end of chapter! Mario has saved the last star spirit, Kalmar, from the crystal palace at the edge of the world. Now, with the 7 star spirits together, he has the power to challenge Bowser and the Star Rod. At last, it is time for Mario's showdown with Evil King Bowser. Can Mario rescue Princess Peach and recover the Star Rod, or will wishes forever go ungranted? So, if you like this video, if you like this chapter, subscribe, rate, comment, check out my Twitter, www.twitter.com/GrandPyromania, and I'll see you guys next time on Let's Play Paper Mario.